Hi, my name is Gary David, and along with being a PhD in sociology, I'm also a certified clinical sociologist. The designation of certified clinical sociologist is a designation that's provided through the Association for Applied and Clinical Sociology. One of the things I'm often asked when I tell people I'm a certified clinical sociologist is, what is clinical sociology? I mean, what does this thing mean? How do I know if I'm a clinical sociologist or not? Well, luckily, there's a lot of information out there to help us understand what that means and to give some insight into whether or not the work you're doing is in that area and how you can do work that fits in that category. So let's take a look. Here's a definition of clinical sociology. Quote, clinical sociology is a creative, humanistic, rights-based, and interdisciplinary specialization that seeks to improve life situations for individuals and groups in a wide variety of settings. Additionally, we can look to the work of Dr. Jan Fritz, one of the preeminent voices of clinical sociology, for the additional description. Quote, clinical sociologists work with client systems, individuals or groups, assisted by a clinical sociologist or an intervention team to assess situations and avoid, reduce, or solve problems through a combination of analysis and intervention. That's a lot of information. Let's talk about each point a little bit in detail to give you a better understanding of what is clinical sociology. First, clinical sociology is creative. It's not formulaic. Creativity is an essential part of the work that clinical sociologists do. It just so happens that creativity is a really important part of what most organizations and businesses try to do. It's through the process of creativity that we're able to come up with solutions for what we may consider to be these wicked problems, these problems that are so complicated that traditional approaches won't work to solve them. Clinical sociology also is humanistic. Clinical sociologists care deeply for the well-being of people, have a strong concern of human welfare, and are also rational in our approaches. We approach topics through careful study and examination, and we use our concepts, our theories, and our methods that we learn in sociology, as well as other methods and theories that we can learn from other disciplines to inform our approach and help us find solutions. Clinical sociology is also rights-based. We believe strongly in the rights of individuals and groups in terms of human rights and their dignity. We are concerned about justice and not just outcomes for those involved, but for all involved in the setting. So we're not only talking about or thinking about those we're working directly with, but we're also thinking about the broader impacts and implications of our work on others that might not have even been initially considered. Clinical sociology is interdisciplinary, and this is the part I really enjoy. I enjoy all of it, but this part I really love. When we talk about being interdisciplinary, we talk about trying to both work with others from different disciplines, but also learn from those different disciplines. We are in many ways trying to broaden our toolbox of approaches, of understanding. And in doing so, not only do we become smarter in the process and more well-rounded, but we also become better able to integrate all of these different influences, all of these different approaches into a more comprehensive framework to help us solve those problems for the people we're working with. Also, it's really important to keep in mind that clinical sociology is a specialization. There's a long legacy of clinical sociology dating back to Lewis Wirth, who coined the term clinical sociology in the 1930s. To be a clinical sociologist requires training. There's apprenticeships, there's mentoring, there's practice, there's dedication, there's working with others who are established. There's some level of experimentation. It's not just about the degree you have. It's not that you need a PhD to be a clinical sociologist, but it's the type of work that you do, and it's that application of your knowledge towards some end, working with a group of people, that makes you a clinical sociologist. Clinical sociology seeks to promote positive outcomes across a variety of settings. We don't just work in one area of specialization. Clinical sociology is not just about working in medical settings. That's not what we mean by clinical. Clinical means creating those interventions. So clinical sociologists can work across any number of domains based on their specialization of training or their evolution of interest. It's really up to you where you want to work and the kind of work that you want to do as a clinical sociologist. Clinical sociology is about intervention and outcome. It's about making things better. It's about trying to improve outcomes, opportunities, situations for as many people as possible. I tell people that as a clinical sociologist, I work with clients to design solutions to help them address and overcome the challenges that they're facing. And that's really what it's about. If you think about a doctor, a medical doctor, you can have a medical doctor who's not a clinician, who does not work with patients, who works in laboratory settings. What makes a doctor clinical is that doctor is working to help diagnose patients and also prescribe solutions to create those interventions to improve whatever challenges they're facing, whether not feeling well, having some kind of illness, or just trying to maintain wellness. Clinical sociology, in the same way, works with others to create interventions to help establish well-being, to help solve problems, and to help deal with situations that they're facing. So hopefully that clarifies what is clinical sociology and what does a clinical sociologist do. If you're interested in finding out more, you can always go to the Association for Applied and Clinical Sociology to learn about what clinical sociologists are doing today. And you can also subscribe to the Journal of Applied Social Science, which is the journal of the AACS, for other current contemporary examples of doing clinical sociology. Or you can find me on LinkedIn to ask any additional questions, just say hi, or to think about ways in which you can apply your sociology degree to become a clinical sociologist. Thanks.